Dile a mi papá que le baje a la...
Good evening, people.
Good evening.
How are you tonight?
Fine, thanks. And you?
Very good, very good. Interesting.
La señora Silvia.
Okay, hello, hello. Let's get it started then. Tonight it is time to start. We're going to start with the first attendance tonight. Okay. Let me start with Wendy Patricia Molina.
Your teacher, good evening.
Good evening, Wendy. Fatima Ifigenia Lopez. Fatima. Vamos a esperar para que conteste. Ada Azucena Cáceres.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Gerson David Menjivar. Madeline Gabriela Alfaro.
Present.
Thank you. Veronica Yesenia. She asked for permission. Jennifer Elizabeth Hueso. Andrés Alberto Orellana. César Humberto López. Jacqueline Vanessa López.
Present.
Okay. Cindy Alexandra Ramos. Carlos Antonio González.
Present.
Thank you. Marlon Ernesto Serrano. Francisca Delmira Guillén. Liliana Melissa Olivares.
Present.
Thank you. Karen Stephanie Flores. María Milagros Rosales.
Present, teacher.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Fátima Ifigenia López.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Very good.
Yes.
I know it's difficult, but it is very important for INSAFOR that you be on time. Yeah. So that's why they want us to get attendance at the beginning of the class, in the middle of the class, and at the end of the class.
Pero ya está la
Nick. I know. Okay. Let's get started tonight with... Now, I want to start with a kind of a game. I'm going to number you in this way. Number one, we're going to have two groups, number one and number two. Ada, you are number one, group number one. Liliana, you are in group number two. Fatima, one. Carlos, two. Wendy, one. Madeline, two. Jacqueline, one. Milagro, two. Jennifer, one. Okay, just to start tonight. This is like a game, a competition between one and two. Group one, with Ada, Fatima, Wendy, Jacqueline, and Jennifer. And group two with Liliana, Carlos, Madeline, and Milagro. But I am going to go one by one. What you have to do is to spell some words. You know what I mean with spell?
Yes.
Okay, yes, that's it. Thank you. So, Ada, easy words, vocabulary we have been studying. Please spell the word vision.
Vision.
Vision. How do you spell vision?
Being I S L E I O M.
Two S.
I know vision. S vision. Ah.
Okay. Okay, I will give you a chance because it's the first time. Okay, 1 point for group number one. Welcome, Cesar. Let me tell you that you are in group number two. Okay, Liliana, how do you spell mission? Very easy.
M-I-S-S-I-O-N.
Yes, very good. Fatima, how do you spell supervisor? Fatima, how do you spell supervisor?
S-U-P-E-B.
No. You made a mistake. Carlos, how do you spell supervisor?
Supervisor, S-U-P-E-R-V-I-S-O-R.
Okay, very good. Point for number two. Now, Wendy. How do you spell floor manager? Floor manager, Wendy.
Manager. F-L-O-O-R-M-A-N-A-G-A-E-R.
E-R, okay, very good. Point for number one.
E-R, sorry.
Madeline, how do you spell maintenance? Maintenance.
M-A-M-T-E-M-E-N.
C-E. Okay, very good. Point for number two.
Me voy a levantar un ratito.
Who said that? Jacqueline. Jacqueline, it's your turn.
Dígamela, porque es que vinieron mis papás y tengo que salir a abrir.
Quickly, how do you spell accountable?
A-C-
No. Go and open the door.
Ya regreso.
Okay. Milagro, how do you spell accountable? Accountable.
No sé.
No? Okay. Jennifer, your turn. Jennifer, are you there?
Yes, I'm here.
Okay, how do you spell accountable?
I-C-C-O-N-I-C-C-O-N.
No. Cesar, how do you spell accountable?
I Yes. Okay. A, C, C, O, U, N, T, A, A, B, L, E.
Yes. Yes, that's right. Okay. Now let's see. Herson, how do you spell safety engineer?
Repeat again, please.
Safety engineer. Safety engineer.
La primera palabra.
Safety. Safety.
Safety engineer.
Yeah.
S-A.
Yes.
F-T-L-Y.
No. Oh, you missed one letter.
No.
No. Safety engineer. Who's the next? Oh, Cindy. Cindy, are you there? Cindy.
Good evening. Entrando voy, teacher.
Yes.
¿Qué es la actividad?
Welcome. How do you spell safety engineer?
Thank you.
Safety engineer.
En español.
No,
por favor,
no,
ayuda.
No.
Que lo deletre.
Safety engineer. How do you spell safety engineer?
Ada tiene ayuda.
Sí, eso veo, eso veo.
Ada tiene
no,
ayuda.
No, okay, Cindy.
Yo necesito ayuda.
Okay. One volunteer. How do you spell safety engineer?
No.
Okay, Ada.
F-A-L-F-A-T-A.
No, no. Somebody from group two? Liliana, yes. Carlos, Madre, César. Milagro, César, or Cindy?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, César. Safety engineer.
S-A-F. E T Y E
E
N G E E
no,
E N
no. Somebody from group number one, safety engineer.
S-S-A F E.
A ver, fueron dos ahí, me perdieron. ¿Quién fue? ¿Jennifer o Jacqueline? ¿Quién va? ¿Quién quiere?
Go Jacqueline.
Go Jacqueline, dice.
Va, yo safe y Jennifer
engineer.
Okay. A F E.
E-N-G-I-N-E-E-R.
Yeah, but Jacqueline didn't finish with safety.
Sorry.
T.
Y.
Y. S-A-F-E-T-Y. E-N-G-I. N-E-E-R, safety engineer. Okay. Very good.
Very easy.
Yeah. Easisísimo. Well, but it is important because tonight you are going to work with a crossword puzzle. If you have seen the book, well, let me share the screen. Yes. Mm-hmm. What happened with this?
No, por qué? Ya. Ay, ya. Ay.
Come on, Zoom. I need to share the screen. Okay, are you watching the book? Hello, can you see the book?
Yes.
Okay. Yes, teacher.
Something is happening. Okay, so this is a crossword, but obviously, unless you have the book, you have printed the book, it's difficult to do it here, but we have the words and the definitions here. And these are basically, this puzzle is based on vocabulary related to values at work. Values at work. Yeah, because that is the third thing we usually have in a company. A vision, mission, and values. Yes? So here are some values, if you can see. Something is wrong with this. Because when I share the screen, I cannot see the book. Okay. So we have empathy. Can you see here? Empathy. Hello, are you looking at the book? Because mi computadora algo pasa.
Yes, we can. Number
one. Yo cuando me pongo en Zoom no logro ver el. Ahora sí. Ahora sí. Okay, empathy.
Number one.
Take it easy. First, let's watch the words, the vocabulary. Okay, repeat, please. Empathy.
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 Responsibility.
Responsibility.
Honesty.
Honesty.
Innovation.
Innovation.
Loyalty.
Loyalty.
Leadership.
Leadership.
Punctuality.
Punctuality.
Efficiency.
Efficiency.
Integrity.
Integrity.
Respect.
Respect.
Okay. I will give you 5 minutes to match the concept or the values with the definitions. Okay, you can write number one and write the value that is defined here. Ponen número uno y ponen el valor que está definido ahí. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Y luego lo revisamos juntos, okay?
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Thank you.
Good evening, teacher.
Good evening. Good
evening. Lo siento por entrar tarde, pero me costó que me entrara. Me decía que si no era un robot y no sé qué. Y lo intenté tres veces.
Oh, okay. No problem, Karen. We are working on page 17 in the book. It's a crossword puzzle.
Yeah.
Yeah. The idea is to, well, here match the concepts with the definition with the of these values. Okay.
I don't understand.
Let me show you. You see the book?
Yes.
This book, so this page in the book is un crucigrama, crossword puzzle.
Oh, okay, okay.
Entonces en esto estamos, básicamente escribiendo el concepto, el valor al lado de cada definición.
Okay. Teacher, por cierto, ¿cuál es el tema que estamos viendo ahorita?
Right now is vocabulary. Estamos aquí en vocabulary practice.
También una consulta, teacher. Pienso de que yo siempre veo los videos de la plataforma en YouTube porque estoy suscrita a Inglés Corporativo.
Uh-huh.
Pero hoy me di cuenta que uno, si uno ve el video a través de la plataforma, le aparece un chequecito. Entonces, quería saber si era necesario que lo viera en la plataforma.
No. Como por evaluación, no. Está bien en YouTube.
Ok. Entonces, voy a trabajar en eso.
Teacher.
Yes.
I have a question.
Tell me.
Loyalty is lealtad.
Yes. Yes, it is.
Okay. Thanks.
Okay.
¿Para qué quieres saber? No, todavía no.
Let me know when you finish.
Teacher.
Ajá. Tell me.
Este, my colleague Marlon Serrano cannot join the class because he has a business event.
Oh, okay.
Uh-huh. Entonces, me pidió que le dijera.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay.
Take note.
Chair.
Hello.
¿Qué era lo que teníamos que hacer en este ejercicio?
Colocar el concepto, bueno, idealmente hacer el crucigrama, ¿no?
Ah, ok.
¿Verdad? Pero como no se puede escribir aquí, ya.
Okay. Ya lo hice.
Perfecto.
Thank you.
Okay, let's check your work, people. I think it's time. Okay, who wants to read number one, please? The definition and the concept.
Me.
Okay, thank you, Liliana.
So the number one is being faithful to your friends, family, principles, etc.
Mm-hmm.
It's loyalty.
Loyalty. Okay, very good. Number two? Guilty. Somebody? Okay, thank you, Jacqueline. Next, Cesar.
The belief that something or someone should not be harmed, treated rudely.
Uh-huh.
I think is respect.
Yes, you're right, respect. Number three, Cesar.
Doing something well and effectively without wasting time, money, or energy.
Uh-huh. Is
efficiency.
Yes, exactly. Okay. Next, number five. Who has number five?
Introduction of new ideas, methods, or inventions is innovation.
Innovation, correct. Number seven.
Seven. The uh-huh. quality of being yes. dependent is responsibility.
Seven, seven.
Seven, size. The seven. Quality of being dependent, responsibility.
Oh, that is six.
That's number six.
Okay. Yo digo es number okay. seven.
Okay, so six is, repeat.
Responsibility.
Responsibility, okay. Responsibility. Number seven.
Being honest and fair and behaving according to the moral principles that you believe in is integrity.
Integrity, yes, good. Now we have number four. Somebody to read number four.
Being good at leading a group, organization, country, leadership.
Leadership, yes. Number eight.
The ability to understand how someone feels because you can imagine what it is like to be them.
Yes.
Empathy.
Yes, empathy. Number nine.
Be teacher.
Uh-huh.
Arriving or being done at exactly the time that has been arranged. Punctuality.
Yes, exactly. And 10. Somebody please.
The quality of being fired and the truthful honesty.
Honesty, yes, very good. Okay, let's practice. I'm going to read to show you the pronunciation and you repeat, please. Okay? Number one, being faithful to your friends, family, principles, etc. Repeat.
Being faithful, friends, family, etc.
Okay. Remember the pronunciation of this is being.
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 Being. Faithful.
Remember that is the verb be. Uh-huh. Faithful.
Faithful.
Okay. Number two. The belief that something or someone should not be harmed, treated rudely.
the belief
that someone rudely. Number three, doing something well and effectively without wasting time, money, or energy.
Doing something well and effectively without wasting time, money, or energy.
Okay, here. Effectively.
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 Five. The introduction of new ideas, methods, or inventions.
The introduction of new ideas, methods, or inventions.
Okay. Seven. Being honest and fair and behaving according to the moral principles that you believe in.
Behaving.
Okay. Behaving. Being good at leading a group, organization, country, etc. Six, the quality of being dependable.
Eight,
the ability to understand how someone feels because you can imagine what it is like to be them. Nine, arriving or being done at exactly the time that has been arranged. And 10, the quality of being fair and truthful.
Fair.
Okay, very good.
¿Cómo se pronuncia la última palabra?
Truthful.
Truthful.
What is fair, teacher?
Fair is like justo.
Ah, okay.
Okay. Fair. Yeah. Los niños cuando se quejan dicen, no es justo, it's not fair.
It's not fair.
Uh-huh. Okay, very good. Now, vamos a ver, quiero ver cuántos estamos. Hey, be careful with the dog. Okay, I'm going to give you one word from this vocabulary to each one of you, okay? And I want you to write a sentence using that word, okay? I don't want the definition. I want you to use that word in a sentence, okay? Let's see. Liliana, I will give you number one, loyalty. Number two, Fatima. Number three, Madeline. Number four, Gerson. Number five, Milagro. Number six, Francis. Number seven, Karen. Number eight, Wendy. Number nine, Cesar. Number 10, Cindy. Number one again, Jacqueline. Number two, Ada. Number three, Jennifer. Number four, Carlos. And number five, Andres. Okay, just one sentence, but using that word, yeah, into the sentence. Give you 3 minutes to do it. Don't go to the translator, okay?
¿Qué es lo que tengo que hacer exactamente, teacher?
A sentence using the word
which word?
No te dije ninguna.
Yes, seven.
Seven. Okay, integrity. According to the activity, to the exercise. Number one is loyalty. Number two, respect. Three, efficiency. Four, leadership. Five, innovation. Six, responsibility. Seven, integrity. Eight, empathy. Nine, punctuality. 10, honesty.
Teacher, no entiendo qué es lo que hay que hacer.
Una oración usando la palabra que le di.
¿Una oración o 10 oraciones?
No, una. Solo con una. La palabra que le di.
Ah.
Usted ya, era entiendo. Innovation.
Sí.
Y mi palabra, teacher, no la escuché. Yo todas estaba haciendo oraciones.
Responsibility.
Okay. Thank you.
O sea, cada quien solo va a hacer una oración. Tiene que ser excelente. When you finish your sentence, please write it in the chat. Write your sentence in the chat. Gracias. Okay, very good, Liliana. Just let me check. So your sentence is in past. Not anymore. Okay, very good, Francis. But responsible está mal escrito en English. Me lo escribí en español. Escríbamelo en inglés, please. Gerson. Staff is a singular word. So have, it must be in third person. Where is Gerson? No, let me see you.
Okay.
Okay. Now it's correct, Francis.
Teacher.
Yes.
Desarrollo es development.
Yes.
Thank you.
Okay. ¿Pueden ver el chat? Y vamos a revisar juntos una por una. Y ustedes van a decir si hay algo que esté que se pueda corregir. Okay, Liliana, can you read your sentence, please? Espero que todos la estén viendo. ¿Están viendo el chat?
Yes.
Entren al chat, vean ahí.
Yes.
Okay.
I wrote two sentences. So the first one is, we admire the loyalty that the employees have to our company. And then I wrote one in present that
aquí mismo en el chat.
Yes.
Okay, let me look.
I wrote, I appreciate the loyalty you have to me.
Aquí está. Oh, this means, okay, here it is. This one.
Teacher, hola.
Hola.
Fíjense de que cuando subo al chat mi oración, aparece el nombre de Liliana.
Tienes que cambiarlo. Ahí en el chat donde dice enviar a, hay una pestaña. Ahí tienes que darle clic y seleccionar todos.
Ah, exacto. Vaya, supongo yo que estoy acá proyectando el chat. ¿Lo pueden ver?
No.
No.
¿Me puede explicar, por favor, nuevamente, Liliana, cómo hago eso?
En el chat, ahí donde usted escribe el mensaje, arriba hay algo que dice enviar a. Parece un desplegable. Entonces ahí le da clic en la flechita del desplegable y selecciona todos. Y luego escribe su texto y le da enviar.
Para escribir en el chat, no sé si le aparecen tres puntitos a la izquierda. No sé quién está preguntando si es mi.
No, madre. Yo ¿no? Sí puedo escribir en el chat, okay. Pero no entiendo cómo hacerlo, lo que Liliana me explica.
¿De dónde usted escribe? Usted y arribita, justo arribita dice enviar a y ahí le aparece el desplegable.
O le va a aparecer en inglés que dice tú, dos puntos, everyone, creo. Entonces en ese desplegable está diciendo Liliana. Así me aparece a mí, everyone.
Entonces, estoy tratando de compartir el chat, pero no. Bueno. Okay, Liliana dijo, I appreciate the loyalty you have to me. Okay, very good. Y había puesto otra, nos dijo, ¿verdad? Solo que el verbo debería ir en presente. We admire the loyalty that the employees have to our company. Okay, very good. Now, about respect. Fátima and Ada, please.
I respect my companions at work.
I respect, okay, my companions.
Companions at work.
At work. Usually, when you talk about the people that work with you, we use the word co-worker. My co-workers.
Okay.
Yeah. I respect my co-workers at work.
At work. Okay.
Or basically my co-workers. Porque ya estás mencionando que son gente del trabajo.
Okay.
Okay. A ver, Ada, ¿qué escribió?
Pero no era con respect, teacher. Era con efficiency. My company is characterized by providing efficient to its customers.
Okay. Muy bien. Now, please, let's continue with Madeline.
The efficiency is very important in my company because we try to better every day.
We try to be better, maybe. Or improve. Sería mejor. We try to improve. Tratamos de mejorar.
Okay.
O ser mejores. Be better. Very good. Next, Jennifer?
If you eat healthy and exercise, you are a more efficient person.
More efficient person. Okay. Good. Difficult, but good. Next, please. Innovation. You think innovation? Milagro?
Cindy Ramos. We at work the innovation in the creation of organic fertilizers with the women's farmers.
Okay. Well, tal vez ahí habría que conjugarlo porque ahí lo estoy usando como verbo. We at work innovate. ¿Verdad? Porque ahí lo está usando como verbo. in the creation of organic fertilizer with the woman farmers. Woman, el plural de woman. What is the plural of woman, people?
Woman.
Woman.
Women.
Se pronuncia women.
Women.
Pero se escribe woman. Y no lleva S. Así como el plural de man is men. ¿Ya? No okay. Lleva S. El plural de woman is women. Women. Okay, very good. Andrés. Andrés.
¿Estás en WhatsApp, verdad?
Yo también tengo innovation, teacher.
Ah, milagro, es cierto. Excuse me. Ya vamos, Andrés. Milagro.
Dale, milagro, no hay problema.
In my company, we put innovation into practice.
Ah, okay. Good. Now, let's go. Andrés, ¿tiene innovation también?
Está bien estructurada la oración, teacher.
We always seek innovation. No.
In my company, we put innovation into practice.
Yeah, yeah, it's good. Okay, Andres.
And the creation and plasmation of the new ideas, it is an innovation in my company.
Okay, la que puso aquí es otra.
No, que son dos. Le acabo de dar la que puse. Ahorita le acabo de decir la que puse primero.
Ya la vi. The creation and plasmation.
Y ahí puse la otra porque no sabía, tenía que ponerlo de la compañía.
Of the new ideas IT. It's an innovation. Okay. La otra que puso.
La última que está en el chat.
Uh-huh. Read it, please.
In my company, we always seek innovation to be competitive in the current market.
Okay, very good, very good. Let's continue with integrity. Karen.
Yes. Spiritual leaders must have moral integrity in order to lead others.
Okay, very good. Eight. Nos saltamos el four. Leadership. Who has leadership? Harrison.
Me. My teams, como me dijo que era singular word, my teams have a good leadership.
Ah, okay. Okay. Y si lo dejábamos como staff, ¿qué había que cambiar?
My staff has a good leadership.
Eso es, exacto. Muy bien. And el otro es Carlos, with leadership. Carlos. He's gone. Okay, let's continue with, bueno, responsibility, el Leo Francis. Empathy, Wendy. Wendy, empathy, exactly, for a psychologist, empathy.
Empathy is the most important skill for the human development of the society.
Okay.
Teacher, I have a skill is the ability.
Skill.
Habilidad.
But I don't know if empathy is a skill. ¿Será una habilidad? Porque skill tiene más que ver con algo que se aprende. ¿Verdad? Pero la oración está bien. Ahí estoy nada más viendo el uso de. Porque skill es algo que tú vas a aprender una habilidad, like alguna cosa, ¿no? Tiene habilidad con las manos, habilidad con...
La diferencia entre uh-huh. skill y ability, ¿cuál es?
Ability es parecido, es la capacidad de hacer algo, ¿no? Abilities that que tenemos, ¿no? Okay, but it's good.
Habilidad.
Habilidad.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Okay. Thank you, Wendy. Punctuality, César.
Okay, punctuality is a very important at our time of us, of our life, because it speaks well of us.
Okay, at all times of our life. Okay, very good. And number 10, honesty. Cindy. Cindy, se nos cayó Cindy.
¿Oración?
Ah, yes.
Hola.
Sí, Cindy. You're...
The honesty is very important for describe a la persona.
Person?
A person.
Okay. Aquí Jacqueline también escribió, you were honest with me once. Ooh. Okay, very good, very good. Bueno, ahí tienen. Sería bueno que después en el foro de discusión de la plataforma escriban eso. ¿Verdad? Esas oraciones para tenerlas ahí en el foro. Okay, let's continue now. We have another activity here. This is, let me share the screen. A review about the infinitive of purpose. This is kind of easy. Correct four mistakes related to infinitives. This is parecido al que hicimos en la lección. Oops, but it's time for the attendance, the second attendance. Yeah. Okay, please quickly, Wendy, Patricia Molina.
Present teacher.
Thank you. Fatima Ifigenia Lopez.
Present teacher.
Thanks. Ada Susana Cáceres.
Present teacher.
Good.
Present.
Yes, thank you, thank you. Gerson David Menjivar.
Present.
Thanks. Madeline Gabriel Alfaro.
Present.
Thanks. Jennifer Elizabeth Hueso.
Present.
Thanks. Andres Alberto Orellana.
Present, teacher.
Thanks. Cesar Humberto López.
Present.
Thank you. Jacqueline Vanessa Lopez. Jacqueline Vanessa Lopez.
Present.
Thank you. Cindy Alexandra Ramos.
Present.
Thank you. Carlos Antonio González.
Present.
Okay. Francisca Delmira Guillén.
Present.
Thank you. Liliana Melissa Olivares.
Present.
Thank you. Karen Stephanie Flores.
Present.
Good. And Maria Milagro Rosales.
Present.
Okay, thank you.
Tengo sueño, teacher.
Drink coffee. Ok, so Milagro nos va a hacer este ejercicio para despertar.
Oh, qué bien.
Um, correct for mistakes related to infinitives. A ver, dígame si está correcta o está incorrecta la primera. The company's mission is to distributing top quality office supplies. It is correct? Is correct or not? Hello? Is it correct or not, people?
Se quedó congelado su imagen, teacher.
Ah, the
company mission is to distributing is wrong.
Okay, distributing.
Ya volvió, teacher.
Sí, mire, yo ni cuenta me fijé. Okay. Sí, es que está algo malo el Inter ahora. This is the mistake, yes.
Pero esto de los verbos, teacher. Ahora. Pero estos verbos infinitivos ya los habíamos visto antes.
Sí, ya los habíamos es que visto esta, antes. Esta lección es un repaso.
¿En la clase de antier o qué?
Yes, esta lección es un repaso.
Entonces, o sea, los verbos infinitivos son los que llevan el ing.
No. El infinitivo es el que lleva to. El infinitivo de work, to work. El infinitivo de eat, to eat. ¿Ya? Entonces, aquí está mal porque los infinitivos no llevan el ing.
Entonces,
esto... está mal.
Tiene que es decir, incorrect.
It's incorrect. This is incorrect. Okay. To distribute.
It's incorrect.
Okay. What about number two?
It's wrong. Okay.
Our vision is. Aquí está mal escrito.
To become
the leaders in the telecommunications sector. So, is correct or incorrect?
Correct.
That's correct.
Correct.
Okay. Esto es lo que estaba incorrecto.
Correct.
Okay. This is correct. Number three.
Qué malo, Andrés.
We exist to provide integrated logistics services. We exist for to provide integrated logistics services. Okay, un error. ¿Cuál es?
It's correct.
It's correct.
No, actually, no. It is not correct. This is incorrect. Why? For. We don't use two prepositions together. Nunca se usan dos preposiciones juntas, ¿no? Y en este caso, to, okay, también. We exist to provide, sin el for. We exist to provide. Next. Dice, our goal is be recognized as the number one dairy producer. What is the mistake? Is correct or incorrect?
Correct.
Correct?
Correct.
No, it's wrong.
Correct.
No.
Two.
Es two.
Missing two?
Ah, yes.
Why?
Two is missing. Two debe de ir aquí, ¿eh? Is?
To be.
To be recognized as the number one dairy producer. Mm-hmm. And Rex envisions to becoming the number one manufacturer of clothes for kids.
Incorrect.
Incorrect. Yes. Why?
Becoming.
Becoming.
Okay, no es becoming, es become. Muy bien, muy bien.
Ya vio que ya estoy despertando.
Eso. Okay, now the next activity is use the words in the box. Use the words in the box to write sentences about your responsibilities at work. Use the words in the box to write sentences about your responsibilities at work. Okay, por lo pronto háganme three sentences talking about your responsibilities at work. Por ejemplo, voy a poner una. Yeah.
Eso, a poner ejemplo. Wow, aplauso.
Hey, ¿qué le pasa?
La violenta.
I am in charge of preparing the lesson plans for my class. Yeah? This is one of my responsibilities at work. Y estoy usando esta, ¿verdad? In charge of. Aquí está. I am in charge of preparing the lesson plans for my class. Now I want you to write three sentences about your responsibilities at work using that vocabulary, those verbs.
Teacher.
Hola.
¿Por qué en el manual, en la primera tiene una X?
¿En cuál primera?
En esta primera, mira.
Espérame, que no
tiene una X. Aquí. No sé si la ve. Pero tiene una X grande.
Ahí donde dice be in charge.
Sí, donde dice be in charge of. Tiene una X. No entiendo por qué.
No.
Estoy como que estuviera mala, pues. Por eso le han puesto una X.
No. No.
Mira. Está...
Sí, sí. La suya, ¿no? Ni nadie más tiene.
¿Y ese usted lo imprimió o ese libro?
Sí, yo lo imprimí. No, yo lo imprimí.
No sé por qué le salió esa X.
Pero tiene una X así grande encima.
Pero no, no. Algo pasó ahí donde se
lo imprimió. Está poseída esta página. Quiere confundirme, pero no lo va a lograr.
No lo va a lograr.
No. ¿Cómo se llama esto? Teacher. Estas in charge of, con my te tú, dedícate tú, responsibility for, accountable for. ¿Cómo se llama eso?
Son verbos. Son verbos. Yo estoy a cargo de... Aquí son expresiones que se usan para hablar de sus responsabilidades. ¿Verdad? Son expresiones, ¿verdad? Lenguaje, vocabulario, que se usa para hablar de sus actividades, de las responsabilidades.
Ya como verbos conjugados.
Es que el verbo prácticamente es solo be. Esto lo estudiamos para cuando vimos este tema. ING forms, después de preposition, se recuerda. Porque lo que es gramaticalmente lo que vimos fue esto. ¿Verdad? Que después de una preposición va un verbo en ING. Eso fue lo que vimos. Y entonces nos dan este vocabulario, este lenguaje, estas estructuras ya de lenguaje que se ocupa para hablar de responsabilidades de trabajo. Que casualmente llevan preposiciones acá.
Esa es una regla, que después de una preposición el verbo va con ing.
Sí, sí, eso es.
Ah, ok. Gracias, teacher.
Ok. Two minutes. Finish?
No.
1 minute.
Okay.
Teacher, me voy a levantar un momentito.
Vaya, pues ahí me trae un cafecito. Okay, now I'm going to send you to small groups and I want you to share, que compartan your sentences. You're going to talk about your responsibilities at work. Okay? Pueden preguntarle a uno a uno, ¿no? Y decirle, "What are your responsibilities at work?" Oh, what do you do at work? Dos maneras que ustedes le pueden preguntar a alguien acerca de qué es lo que hace en su trabajo. What do you do at work? ¿Verdad? O what are your responsibilities at work? ¿Ok? Y practican ahí y comparten lo que han escrito. ¿Ok? join your groups, please. Join your groups and practice.
De ahí, había puesto que I am committed to work in weekend. Es también mentira, pero yo lo puse.
Pero no entendí.
I am committed to work in weekend or in Saturday. Pero es mentira porque siempre estoy ocupada los fines de semana y no voy. Trabajo de lunes a viernes y cuando me dicen, ¿puede trabajar sábado? No, no puedo. Y ya. Y es que es mi único día libre. Y luego había puesto, I am responsible for the class of nutrition.
Okay.
Es el 3.
Sí, que he hecho 3, pero porque repetí la de Shanghai. Hice 2 oraciones de la misma.
Ah, pero cuenta la otra que hizo.
¿Ah? Cuenta.
Esta es la otra que hizo.
A person in charge of hearing.
No entendí.
Person in charge of the hearing. Contratación.
Estoy a cargo del personal de contratación, algo así.
Ajá.
Así es.
Ajá, ya entendí. No, hombre, tampoco hay que meterse con ella en eso.
Kelly.
Okay. Andrew.
What do you do at work, Andrés?
I am responsible for attendance, call, and receive visit in the office. I am dedicated to send emails to my clients. And I am charge of the administrative area of the department.
Okay.
Okay, thank you.
Y Wendy se salió.
La cambiaron, la que se salió.
La sacaron.
Porque de repente desapareció. La mandaron a otro grupo.
La salieron.
No.
La cambiaron de grupo.
Changed. Her internet is. I think she has problem with the internet.
La vio el teacher que mucho molestaba. Luego la cambió.
Mucho relajo está haciendo.
Okay. Keep talking, but in English. Okay.
Okay, teacher.
See nice. Ya.
Okay.
Responsible is be responsible for the training my colleagues based on the new technology and the commitment to providing medical technical assistance for the new products. And I am a charge of the attending the surgery.
De cirugías.
Oli.
De cirujana.
Yes.
Yeah.
Uy, bárbara.
Yeah.
Yo solo de ver sangre me muero, de acuerdo.
Usted es especialista en quesadillas.
Exactly.
Really?
Jennifer, what do you do at work? Jennifer.
I am charged of having the report reading at the end of the day. And I am responsible for the cleaning staff.
O sea que ustedes no lo hicieron como oraciones, ¿verdad?
Sí.
¿Sí?
¿Cómo no?
Sí.
Ah, ya.
Yes.
A ver, pues, pregúnteme.
What do you do at work?
Harrison, what do you do at work?
I am responsible for
making making the balance sheet and profit and loss report and check the bank of account. And you, Fatima?
I am responsible for sending email a customer care. I am in charge of calling assist customer.
And you, What do you do at work, Madeline?
I am accountable for checking the general balance, and I am responsible for paying bills to suppliers.
Nice.
And that's it. Solo esa era. Yes.
Ah, okay. No, no problem. It's good.
And only that.
What is you accountable for? Sí, sí, ¿verdad?
El teacher anda tomando café ahorita.
Anda del baño ahorita.
Ya vino, ve.
Hoy podíamos salirnos temprano de la clase.
Hasta saboreándose viene, haciéndole así.
Ya ve, usted también había hecho eso, milagro, para que le fuera el sueño.
Pero no, yo me puse
ya veo bien despierta, la milagro. Yo.
Eso, milagro.
Milagros. Milagros.
Oh, ya despertó.
Tú eres nuestra voz.
Ah, qué bien.
Wow.
Vámonos todos ya.
Okay. Let's hear about your responsibilities. I want to hear about your responsibilities. And ah. I'm going to start with.
Ah, le voy a poner el terapé.
Well, okay, let's start with Milagro. Milagro, tell me about your responsibilities at work.
Bravo, sí, yes, Milagro, Milagro.
Everybody, Milagro, Milagro.
Es un complot.
Por no, supuesto, Milagro.
Sí, Milagro. Everybody, sí, Milagro. ¿Cómo va a escucharla?
Ay, sí, cómo no. Ok, bueno, acepto correcciones, ¿ok?
Ok.
I am in charge of signing the checks for the supplies. Oh, I am ¿cómo se pronuncia esa palabra, teacher? Dedicated to.
Dedicated to.
Pronunciation.
Dedicated to.
I am dedicated to making the goods of the merchandise. Merchandise. Así se pronuncia.
Merchandise, okay.
I am responsible for dispatching the seller.
Excellent. That's it. Hey, very good. Please, everybody, a virtual applause for Milagro. Show your applause on your screen. Okay. Very good. Very good.
Good. milagro.
Cuatro días es lo único que he hecho.
He ganado una ausencia en la semana. O sea, mañana
no me voy a... No.
Ya se puede ir a descansar.
No, es que mire.
Ya se puede ir a la maca.
Teacher, ayer me le corrí. Pido una disculpa, pero yo no aguanto ver sueño.
I know, okay.
Solo fue media horita.
Milagros, drink to Red Bull. Please.
Drink Red Bull.
No, ese es dañino
para la salud. No se va a poder dormir.
Red Bull is bad.
Eso es dañino para la salud. Mejor una cervecita bien.
Le va a dañar el corazón. Eso. No, la cerveza le va a aumentar el estómago, la grasa abdominal, eso tampoco.
Ay, gracias, Jacqueline, tienes razón.
Jacqueline, Liliana is listening to you. And they sell liquor.
Lo siento, Liliana.
The chicken drink.
Hablaba de la cerveza.
Whiskey.
You
no,
promise.
No, that's no, true. No, pero nos puede dar un vinito rico.
Whiskey.
The wine has sugar, so I'm not sure.
No.
Maybe whiskey or vodka or even better, tequila.
Really?
Yes.
We must have a meeting with you, Liliana. To try. We can visit you there.
En Navidad. In
not sure about that.
Okay. Pass the ball, Milagro, to someone else.
Excuse me?
Pass the ball. Pásale la pelota. Alguien más. Pass the ball.
Otra víctima.
Andrés.
Andrew.
Okay.
Revenge. Sounds like a revenge.
Good. Don't worry.
Okay.
I am responsible for attendance, call and receive visit in the office.
Okay, I am responsible for attending. Yeah, remember, after a preposition, the verb must be in ING.
Attending, call,
attending and receiving. Attending and receiving.
No, it's attending call.
Attending calls, okay.
And receiving visits.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
In the office.
Okay, very good. Pass the ball, Andres.
Hola.
Oh.
La vieron muy calladita, Ada.
Sí, demasiado tranquilita.
But, okay.
You can do it.
My responsible at work. My responsible for training my colleagues based on the new technology. I am in charge of attending the surgeries and committed to the providing medical technical assistance for the new products.
Okay.
Hay que tenerle miedo a Ada porque espinas
en el cuchillo. Surgeries. The word is surgeries.
Surgeries.
Uh-huh. Okay. Very interesting.
It's the new technology.
Wow. Excellent. People, if you need a surgery, go with Ada. Okay, Ada, pass the ball, please.
Pass the ball and... Harrison?
Ada, no.
Sí.
Okay, Ada.
Sorry.
No problem.
Don't be sorry. Don't be sorry.
Ada, I am responsible.
Responsible.
Responsible for making the bank, the check, no, making the balance sheet of my company and check the balance of account.
Checking
the balance of account and making the reconciliation of account, the balance of account.
Okay, good. Thank you. Pass the ball, Harrison. Okay.
Harrison, ahí está Madeline.
The next victim is
Madeline. Madeline.
Cesar.
Okay.
Oh. Okay, no problem. Okay. I am responsible for calling my customers daily. I am in charge of the projects of the company, and I am committed to my activities.
Okay, but I need a verb after the preposition. The first sentence is perfect. Just for lo que estamos estudiando. Can you repeat the second one, please?
I am in charge of the project of the company.
Okay, podríamos usar I am in charge of checking. Usar un verbo después. I am in charge of checking the projects of the company.
Ah, okay.
Estarlo revisando. ¿Y la otra era?
I am committed to my activities.
I am es el verbo to be.
Uh-huh.
Okay, no necesita decir I am be. I am committed.
Okay.
To my activities.
La alarma.
Yeah, that is for the attendance. Si no se me olvida.
Sí. Present teacher.
Vamos a empezar de abajo para arriba. No.
Sí, por
se
favor.
Se nos va milagro. No, se nos va.
Milagro. Que se cierre milagro. Última teacher, por favor.
Pero no se vaya.
No, justo.
Ok, milagro.
No,
milagro.
Falta milagro.
Sí, se va. Karen y Stephanie.
Le vamos a mandar un café.
Okay. I am here.
Liliana Melissa.
Present.
Thank you. Francisca Delmira.
Present.
Carlos Antonio. Carlos Antonio. Miren, se nos dio la fuga, ve. Cindy Alexandra.
Ramos. Present.
Okay.
Present.
Jacqueline Vanessa López.
Present.
Good. César Humberto López.
Present.
Thank you. Andrés Alberto Orellana.
Present.
Good. Jennifer Elizabeth Hueso. Jennifer.
Present.
Thank you. Madeline Gabriel Alfaro.
Present.
Erson David Menjivar.
Present.
Ada Susana Cáceres.
Present.
Fátima Ifigenia López.
Present.
Wendy Patricia Molina.
Present, teacher.
Okay, the last activity here is very simple. The difference between personal and personnel. Let me share the screen. Okay. The difference between these two words, personal and personal. ¿Cuál de estas significa belonging to a particular person? El significado de una es este, belonging to a particular person, y el de la otra es people who work for a company. ¿Cuál es cuál?
Personnel con E.
Ajá.
Is company.
People who work for a company. And personal? is belonging to a particular person. Pertenecer a alguien en particular, ¿verdad? Una persona. No. Okay. The cell phone is a personal device. Yes? The cell phone is a personal device. Es un dispositivo personal. And when we talk about the staff of a company, we can use the word personal. Or not personal. In Spanish es la misma palabra, but not in English, okay? And here you have some sentences and you have to write the correct word. Number one, now, who is responsible for the personnel or personal at the plant?
Personal.
Okay. Personnel. Okay. Who is responsible for the personnel at the plant? Number two. Does the marketing manager have a
personal assistant?
Personal assistant.
Personal
assistant.
This? Correct. Number three. It is necessary to train more
personal.
Personal.
Uh-huh.
For the high season.
Okay. Number four, please do not bring your
personal problem to the office.
Personal problems, okay. And five.
Personal.
Personal.
And the personal
of the workshop need new uniforms.
Okay, very good. Let's practice. Who is responsible for the personnel at the plant? Repeat.
Who is responsible
for the personnel
at the plant?
Does the marketing manager have a personal assistant?
Does the marketing manager have a personal assistant?
It's necessary to train more personnel for the high season.
It's necessary to train more personnel for the high season.
High season.
High season.
Please do not bring your personal problems to the office. The personnel of the workshop need new uniforms.
The personnel of the workshop need new uniforms.
Okay, any question?
Teacher, yo tengo una pregunta. Dígame. Pero respecto a la clase de ayer, creo que esa fue, sobre la voz pasiva.
Ajá.
No entiendo muy bien. ¿Cómo usarla?
Ok.
Estaba viendo, en la tarde vi el foro y vi que había puesto que pusiéramos oraciones de la compañía con voz pasiva.
Ok. The passive voice is used to emphasize in the action or in the object of the receiver of the action. Déjame compartir pantalla acá. Y moverme a lo que vimos ayer. Ok, aquí está. Dice acá, use the passive voice to emphasize that the actions are more important than the doers. Las acciones son más importantes que quien las hace. ¿Verdad? Que quien las hace. Y voy a mostrarle acá también. La presentación vimos aquí arriba. Ok, acá estábamos comparando lo que se conoce como active voice, donde enfatizamos en quién hace las cosas. Acá. Y la passive voice, donde el énfasis está más en la acción. Ok. Por ejemplo, cuando yo digo people know Rex products, no, people know Rex produces clothes with modern designs for kids. La gente sabe que Rex produce, ¿verdad?, ropa con diseños modernos para niños. Entonces aquí el énfasis está en people, ¿verdad? La gente sabe. Pero acá ya ni siquiera mencionamos people, sino...
Teacher, si está compartiendo la presentación de PowerPoint, sí. ¿Cómo se ve el manual?
Perdón.
Ajá, el manual, estoy viendo.
Oops, sorry. Esta cosa. No. Acá. Ahora sí. Ahora sí se ve la presentación.
Yes.
Okay. Entonces le decía, people know Rex produces clothes with modern designs for kids. El énfasis está en people, el que hace la acción, ¿verdad? En esta oración, people hace la acción y Rex es lo que se conoce como objeto, es el que recibe la acción. La gente conoce a Rex. No, es people es el sujeto. People es el sujeto, es el que hace. People know. La gente sabe o conoce. ¿A quién conoce? A Rex. Rex es el objeto, lo que se conoce como el objeto, el que recibe el efecto de la acción. Entonces, en la passive voice, como el énfasis no está en quién lo hace, sino en la acción misma y en quién la recibe, cambia el orden, ¿no? Y decimos, Rex is known for the modern designs. Rex es conocida por sus diseños modernos. Por eso se llama pasiva, porque no estamos enfatizando a quién hace. Es esa otra voz activa, sino que estamos enfatizando a quién recibe la acción. Y la estructura de esto es siempre el verbo to be más el past participle del verbo que estamos usando.
Okay.
Va a ser la estructura siempre. Por ahí en el grupo de WhatsApp les puse un par de cosas para reforzar este tema. Ahí también nos puede ver.
Oh, okay, teacher.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay, yes. People, it's time. ¿Verdad? Ya algunos ya se me dieron a la fuga. Okay. Have a good night.
Good night.
Thank you for coming.
Good night, everybody.
And see you tomorrow.
Good night.
Remember the platform, okay?
Good. Very good.
Bye-bye.